You are now ready for your next step on the road to real chess understanding. How to plan. This tutorial will focus on the strategic concept of the pawn structure and using space. What does the term pawn structure mean? Some chess teachers also use the term pawn skeleton, which is more illustrative. What both of these terms mean is that if you strip the position of pieces and leave only the pawns on the board, you will clearly see how to plot your strategy. Taking the starting position and removing all the pieces reveals the pawn skeleton. Remembering the ancient battlefield analogy, it stands to reason that if an opening of the ranks can be forced upon the opponent, then our army could flood into that breach and quickly capture the opponent's pieces, or even worse, the king. What do I mean? The open file. We remove both white and black d pawns. The d file is open because there are no pawns on it. Why are open files important? Well, can you think of any piece that will benefit by sitting on an open file? If you said rook or queen, reward yourself with a cookie. And send me one too. Rooks love open files. This strategic principle only stands to reason. Look at the next example. Both sides have the same seven pawns as before. I've just added a rook to each side. If it were White's turn to move, he should do himself an important strategic favor and move his A1 rook to the D1 square as quickly as possible. Why? Because on the D1 square, White's rook would be mobilized or developed to a position which would allow penetration into the opponent's camp. From Black's perspective, he should try to use the same idea too. If he could play rook A8, D8, then Black's rook would be developed on the open D file and he would be primed to shoot down the D-file and invade White's position. Here is the same diagram with a slight change. The C2 pawn has moved a file over to become a D2 pawn. Are there any open files? There are no files that are clear of all pawns. Thus, the answer is no. There are no open files. From White's perspective, he has a half-open C file. What this means is that White has no pawns sitting on the C file. This makes the C file open to White. Since Black has a C7 pawn, the C file is closed to Black. The presence of only one pawn means that the C file is half open. White should move his rook from A1 to C1, grabbing his half open file. Although the rook isn't as powerful on a half open file as it is on an open file, White has to make do. Not every position has an open file. In this case, White's rook is best placed on the C file. Here is a pawn skeleton with rooks. What are the open files? There are none. What are the half-open files? White's half-open file is the C file. Black's half-open file is the E file. you notice how White's f2, e3, and d4 pawns are linked together? Pawns that are linked together are called pawn chains. In this pawn chain, the base pawn is the f2 pawn. The base pawn is quite important, since it is the foundation upon which the entire pawn chain rests. The strength or weakness of the pawn chain is determined by the base pawn. If it is strong, the pawn chain will remain powerful and intact. If weak, the entire chain is in danger of collapse. Let's now turn to Black's pawn structure. His pawn chain of b5, c6, and d5 pawns has an unfortunate disadvantage. His base pawn is the c6 pawn, which sits on White's half-open file. This means that White's rook will shift over to the half-open C file and put a lot of pressure on Black's c6 pawn. If the base pawn falls to the moves 1 rook c1 and 2 rook takes c6, you can bet that the next move will be 3 rook c5. Then Black's pawn chain will be wiped out, as the b5 and d5 pawns both lack protection. Look again at this diagram. With the limited information we now know, we can already perceive that White should start with the move 1 rook c1. I reward this move with an exclamation mark to note the excellence of the move. White understands that by bringing his rook to the half-open file, he first develops his rook and secondly puts pressure on Black's pawn structure, forcing him to respond. Black, aware that his pawn chain is in immediate danger, is quick to respond with 1 rook c8. This marks a concession. Both army leaders know that Black's rook would prefer to go to the half-open E file, but Black has no time. If he were to play 1 rook e8 in order to defend his c6 pawn with 2 rook e6, he would be too late. After 1 rook c1, rook e8, I place a question mark after this move to denote it as a mistake. 2 rook takes c6. White carries out his operation and wins Black's base pawn. Soon the rest of Black's pawn chain would fall. Black's decision to play b7, b5 has weakened his pawn structure. Thus the moves 1 rook c1 and 1 rook c8 have been played. This brings us to our next example. Here we can see that Black's c8 rook is tied down to the defense of his c6 pawn. Now why is this? The problem with the c6 pawn is that it can't be protected by another pawn. The pawns that flank the c6 pawn, the b5 and d5 pawns, have both shot past the c6 pawn. The result is that the c6 pawn has been left behind. In chess parlance, the c6 pawn is identified as a backward pawn. Backward pawns tend to be weak because they need the protection of other pieces. That is, such pawns as backward pawns can't count upon the protection of other pawns. As a result, backward pawns are a liability for their owners. Several other points about this pawn structure should be clarified. The first thing is that white's pawns are separated into two pawn islands. What do I mean? Well, a file, in this case the C file, separates white's pawns into two distinct groups. The first group, the A2 and B2 pawns, forms its own pawn island. The second group, the D4, E3, F2, G2, H2 pawns, forms the second, larger pawn island. This concept of different pawn islands is important. The more pawn islands a player has, the weaker his position becomes. Once again, the reason for this is that pawns, being the weakest team members, require protection. If our pawn islands are broken up into smaller and smaller groups, their need for protection increases. Sometimes our ability to protect them doesn't equal their need. Black also has two pawn islands. The A7, B5, C6, and D5 pawns make one. The F7, G7, H7 pawns make up the second. In the question of Black's first pawn island, it is important to note that Black's A7 pawn, while not touching or in connection with the B5 pawn, is still a part of the pawn island. If Black didn't have a B pawn, the A7 pawn would constitute a pawn island of its own. By looking at the pawn islands of a given position, a principle on how to play that particular position becomes clear. The player with more pawn islands will have more difficulties in the ending than his opponent will. Remember that pawns and pawn islands require protection. As more pieces are exchanged, our ability to protect our pawns becomes less and less. Soon the player with more pawn islands will have more to worry about. A new position is created. Visually, it seems this position is fairly balanced. It is not. White has a near decisive advantage. The pawn structure tells us that white has a passed pawn. The D5 pawn is a passed pawn because its path to promotion is not blocked by a black pawn. Also, its march up the board cannot be stopped by a black pawn. As chess great Aaron Nimzowitsch said, a passed pawn is a criminal who should be put under lock and key. Yes, but who will play guard? a piece. This means that the d5 pawn, a passed pawn, has grown in value. Once he was equal to other pawns, but now a piece will have to be assigned to watch him. Analyzing this pawn structure also gives us an additional secret. The d5 pawn is a protected passed pawn. The fact that it is protected by the e4 pawn raises the status of the d5 pawn even more. A passed pawn would quickly promote itself if not watched by an opposing piece. All else being equal, which recapture by white is better? Correct. What is a desirable move for white? That's right. For black, that's correct. Now that white has gained control of the open file, what next? You got it right. For black, correct. Are there any open files? That's right. What kind of file is this one? That's correct. How many pawn chains does white have? You got it right. How many pawn chains does black have? Correct. What type of pawn chain is this? That's right. What type of pawn chain is this? That's correct. What is White's move? You got it right. What is Black's move? Correct.